Well, welcome to the Royal Astronomical Society's YouTube channel once again. I'm Robert Massey, and this is Marieke Baan from the European Astronomical Society. And we're here to talk to a distinguished group of guests about collaboration between Africa and Europe in astronomy. There are a large number of delegates in the African continent here. We're delighted by that. And I'll now hand over to Marieke to bring them in.
Thank you. We welcome Mirjana Povic, Michael Buckets, and Kevin Govender. Please, could you briefly introduce yourselves?
Okay, thank you very much. You said I'm Mirjana Povic, so I'm an astrophysicist, and currently I'm working as a researcher and professor at the...
I'm Michael Buckes. I'm senior lecturer in the Department of Physics at the University of Namibia. I'm there also head of the Namibian HASS research group for the High Energy Stereoscopic System, which is the world-leading gamma-ray astronomy instrument, which is situated in Namibia, also involved in the Southern African Regional Office of Astronomy for Development, and also in local outreach activities.
I'm Kevin Govender. I'm the director of the Office of Astronomy for Development. This is a joint project between the International Astronomical Union and the South African National Research Foundation. Our objective is, how do we use astronomy to make the world a better place?
Why is it so important that this EWASS, this topic is so prominent?
Yes, so today we had a session, and then the large session as well, regarding the astronomy and space science the connections between Europe and Africa. So we believe that this was really the proper moment to suggest this topic for EWASS, because until recently, South Africa was the only reference regarding the development of astronomy and space science in Africa. But since some 5-6 years ago, many other African countries, sub-Saharan African countries and Maghreb as well, started with the institutional development, with the establishing the space agencies, new research centers, then with the human capacity buildings, with new master PhD programs. So there is a huge motivation on the continent, and also African Union its objectives in order to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals proposed the use of space science and technology as one of the tools and one of the important tools. So putting all this together, we really believe that it's really the right moment to work on this. And today we found a lot of motivation, a lot of projects going on. So we believe that in future we can work more on establishing the links, networks, in order to strengthen more the connections between Europe and Africa.
Kevin, how can astronomy for development make the world a better place?
Well, that's our challenge. I mean, you know, there are huge issues in the world, and it's different in different parts of the world. The closest we have is the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. And so we try to say, and we try to put out a challenge every year, we call out openly to people to submit projects that use astronomy or some part of astronomy, the technology, the data, the skills, to impact in some way the Sustainable Development Goals. With regard to the session today and the Africa-EU partnership, Africa-Europe collaborations, one of the biggest challenges we have in the world is inequality. This is such an unequal planet we live on in terms of the people. What we found today was that it's an opportunity where you take people with at different levels of progress in terms of astronomy, put them together and see what a difference it makes when opportunity is given to everyone. And we find that when there's opportunity, then some of the best minds in the world emerge from some of the conventionally unlikely places.
Yeah, I mean, Kevin, you have it's fair to say, a global reputation in this kind of work, and you're highly regarded in it. One of the things that strikes me quite often when I deal with people here in the UK is that they still tend to take a kind of, let's take our expertise and give it to Africa. And that does trouble me, because I think about that capacity building side and the way in which it should be more of a genuine partnership. So do you feel that the new work, for example, around SKA is going to overcome that? You know, will it be sufficiently be locally grown that you actually see African countries developing to become global partners in their own right, rather than somehow, you know, dependent on this largesse, which always troubles me. You know, I just think it can't be the right relationship long term.
Yeah, that's a very good question, because, you know, if everyone had the same opportunity, who would fare better? If you take away all privilege from the world today, who would survive? It's those without privilege today. It's that challenges make us stronger. And the challenges that people face on the African continent make them able to do things that in a way that maybe the Europeans haven't thought of yet. So bringing that ingenuity to the broader field of science, of astronomy, taps into an innovative a power that contributes to the field as a whole. So it's not about giving skills or like aiding Africa. It's about giving Africa opportunity to shine, because they can do things. You know, when the playing fields are level, you're going to find that in many ways Africa will beat the rest of the world. And SKA is an example of that.
Michael, you work at the University of Namibia. In Namibia, there are several examples of collaborations between Namibia and European countries. Can you explore a little bit on that?
Yeah, well, they since quite a while, the high energy stereoscopic system, which I named a little earlier. So that is actually a large sort of big science project with more than 250 people, scientists being involved from 13 different countries, most of them being in Europe, but also South Africa and Namibia being involved. And that has been running since, well, started building 2002, started a science operation in 2004. And also there in that context, I would feel that what colleagues have said, that currently there's, in that sense, the right time, as you mentioned, as the way of thinking of people is starting to change and compared as it was to 10 years ago. Well, in Namibia, there is specific challenges in terms of low numbers of people being involved. Namibia has a very low population altogether, and so there haven't been many Namibian students being involved 10 years ago. But actually currently they are, and there's currently a good number of masters and even a few PhD students that get involved in house. In addition, there is also quite a number of new projects that are starting to launch or that are in preparation phase. Connected to the SKA, there's the African VLBI network, the AVN, and also there's a fairly new initiative being called the African Millimeter Telescope, where we are together with mainly colleagues from the Netherlands, but also all over Europe, are trying to build the first ever millimeter wave radio telescope in Africa. And there actually Namibia is astronomically quite a good location, because it has some of the clearest in terms of on the one hand, non-polluted, on the other hand, cloudless skies you would find in the world. It's additionally quite highly elevated above sea level. So there are not many places in the world you can do astronomy better than you could do from Namibia. But that's a potential which has not been fully been exploited, but we're trying with our European friends to tap into that.
To ask a sort of provocative general question, because I'm just thinking back to the Apollo program in the 1960s, and even in the US, by far the wealthiest country on Earth, it was controversial. The level of spending was extremely high. There's a famous New York Times cartoon of an Apollo launch, I think even Apollo 11, next to a lot of starving people. Do you find that the local populations in different African countries countries are supportive of these efforts? Are they controversial there? Or is there some kind of general realization this is an essential program? I'm genuinely interested because it's in the UK, for example, I think you'd find a lot of people like this science, but they wouldn't necessarily want to see more money spent on it.
Can I comment on that? Yes. So I can put Ethiopia as one of the examples, no, because the country is really facing many problems, many challenges, and in the same time it's also facing one of the highest economical growths, no, in the past 10 years. And the program in Ethiopia is totally supported. It's run by the government and the Ministry of Science and Technology, and they're really seeing investing in the, it's really looking into the future, no, but they're really seeing investing in space science and technology in order to improve some of the main challenges of the country. So it's not only the astronomy, no, it's like space science in general, and this is something that, I mean, the general motivation that we have on the continent, you know, so astronomy is one part, you know, and it can contribute in many different aspects, but then it's space science in general, and we know, like, we know that nowadays satellite data are basically everywhere, and our daily life depend on that. So in case of Ethiopia, we are planning to use the satellite data, to launch the satellite, to use the satellite data to really improve some of the main challenges, like access to the water and fight against the chronic droughts that Ethiopia has, to improve the food security and to improve the agricultural production, to improve the access to the electricity, because still only 25% of the population has the access to the electricity, and then to improve all the like economical growth through the industry, infrastructure, and even use the satellite data for the like telemedicine, teleeducation as well. So there are many, many applications that you really can, I mean, and as I mentioned, under the African Union, they really also focused on the highlighted use of the satellite data and the space science in general for achieving the sustainable development goals. So it's very important.
Okay, I think that's a great answer, actually, and a great way to end it. And, you know, obviously we're sympathetic to this because we're the RAS, but it's just, you know, we want to expand these questions. So thank you to everybody for being here today once again. And we'll be back, I guess, either later today or tomorrow with more broadcasts from the RAS YouTube channel. Thank you for listening.
Thanks for joining.